Well, where are we?
Oh, we started already?
Yep, we're going.
Hey, this is Vicky.
Welcome to the Biscuit, Unit 311. Come on in. Come on in. Here is my beautiful hallway. Which you wait, once we get down there, we have the fantastic reveal. But for now, we'll enjoy the hallway with the family photos. My two fabulous children. Some Chinese artwork, a bookshelf. Which is very well laid out with my favorites and my not-so-favorites. And the ones that I absolutely need to read still. We're walking down the hallway.
How high are these ceilings?
These ceilings are, they're actually 14 and a half feet to the bottom of the beam, so 16 feet to the ceiling. In this building, the third floor and the sixth floor, I believe, have the highest ceilings. Everything else is a couple of feet shorter. So we're coming in, we see our kitchen in front of us. The kitchen that was originally here when I bought the unit, which is a corner unit, which is the reason really why I couldn't resist it. Come on, Ted, look at the window.
Wow. How big are those windows?
You know, I guess your guess is as good as mine. They've got to be about 8 feet in windows.
It's and these amazing. Are the original.
These are the original windows. Watch. The way they open down is amazing. It's like, oh! This is a big industrial. Look at that, isn't it crazy? It's raining outside. We get some rain in Los Angeles, which is fantastic.
And that's south-facing, right?
This is south-facing, so we get light all day long. In the summer, the sun is actually overhead, so it's not too strong. In the winter, it tends to come in a little bit through the windows, but if you look up, you'll see, I'll operate them a little bit later, we've got the shades, the solar shades that will come down and take care of any excess sun.
Now you're something about a UV.
Yeah, on the windows when I first moved in just to protect my artwork and my furniture, I put a UV film on the windows. So basically what it blocks out a lot of the heat and doesn't really affect, you can see on the windows, doesn't really affect the, you know, the coloring or the way you see out the windows, but it does protect you from the UV.
It's actually raining today.
I know, it's raining today. And what I chose to do is actually put this piece over here, which is where I keep all my glasses, plates, crockery, what have you. And it's sort of nice because it brings the kitchen into the then dining room arena.
So you have a lot of wood in the place.
A lot of, yeah. I decided to bring in a lot. You know what I found is so many people were taking these loft spaces, which were fabulous sort of modern interpretations of an old warehouse and continuing with the modern theme. I'm a little bit obsessed with the non-modern as far as design is concerned, so I wanted to bring a lot of wood and just sort of earthy, more rustic tones and feelings and textures into the place, but also somehow keep it modern. I think I achieved it. I think it works. I've got a pretty eclectic mix, but it's really comfortable and cozy. I'm just going to close the window.
Because it's raining.
Because it's raining.
I just did the reveal.
You did the reveal.
Partial reveal here.
There's my friend Joe sitting over there on the couch. Hi, Joe.
Hello.
And Toulouse. So what's fantastic about this is we've got the kitchen.
What isn't, right?
Well, it's really great for social people. When people come over, which I tend to have nice little gatherings and parties, this always seems to be the place people congregate first. And then slowly we move into this arena, which is just a nice little small living room area. And then often we move further back. That's an area I'll show you a little bit more about.
So we still have more windows. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Exactly. 12 sets of windows. Sunday, for example, really hot day. I had a big brunch party here. It had been raining all week. We decided to have the party here because it was possible rain. Turned out it was not raining at all. I opened up every single window completely, and it was like we were outside. It was amazing because the breeze was coming in from all areas. It was pretty fantastic. So this is our secondary living room. We see here my bedroom, which has, as my ex-husband like to point out, he said, Vicky, why do you have revolving doors to your bedroom? Which I thought was quite funny coming from an ex-husband. Yeah. I didn't really know what to say to that. I do, apparently, have revolving doors in my bedroom. So yeah, this is my bedroom. And I just like the idea of having somewhat of a partition. It keeps, believe it or not, keeps some of the sound out. And when I do have people staying, which is in an area over here, there's a little bit more privacy. And we can actually go in through this entrance.
Oh.
Yeah, you see?
I didn't even notice that.
We have a formal bedroom entrance. Welcome. And it's just really simple. It does what it needs to do. We have a big closet with all sorts of space.
Can you show me that?
I can show you. I can't guarantee it's going to be tidy.
Cool.
You know, so we got all the drawers you could possibly want.
Nice.
Hanging space on the other side.
You have a ceiling fan?
We have a ceiling fan, which actually is amazing. It helps a lot and just keeps all the air moving. It cools down this room in the summer if you don't feel like blasting the air conditioning all the time, which is kind of nice not to have to do that. And then we have the master bathroom, in here, which is a really nice big space. Totally works pretty simply done. I haven't built it out. I just chose to just use pieces of furniture. The shower wall.
Wow, it has like
marble. Oh, the water pressure is spectacular.
Nice.
Amazing.
Two sinks.
Two sinks, and his and
perfect,
her.
Perfect, perfect.
Perfect for my revolving doors.
Just in case.
Just in case, you never know. And then, the bathroom, the toilet area.
All right, toilet back there.
There we go.
Wow.
What are we laughing about?
Just this desk?
Oh, isn't it
Where's
beautiful?
This furniture from? I mean, there's...
This is Indonesian. I just got... It was... I'm actually sitting outside in some Indonesian store, and they were just trying to get rid of it. It was all weathered and nasty, and I sort of fell in love with it and refinished it a little bit, and here it is. This is from the thrift store. Many things in my house are from the thrift store. But I don't know. I just have this way of...
Finding the right thing.
Repurposing, I guess the word is. Now, you may notice these lovely 10-foot Moroccan doors. Well, you may not have known they were doors, but check it out. They are, in fact, doors. And when I got the space, this was all open completely. And for me, it was really important because I have two teenage boys. They needed space to live. They needed space when they came. They could actually have their entire independent space. And, you know, I needed it too. So I found these doors. I decided it was probably a really good way to make the space work as far as just dividing the space. I actually got them completely. I found them online in Austin. They're from Marrakesh. I ordered them hoping to God they were going to work because they weren't cheap. And turned up and they did not be better. Ready? Like being a princess.
That is awesome.
Isn't that awesome? So we can do that on the side if we want. Which is really nice too, even if you have people over, just sort of, it's a whole different feeling. Like these two rooms can be.
So at least you can tell your kids to honestly go to their room.
Yeah, go to their room, exactly. So now the other amazing thing about what I did here, I'm patting myself on the back, I guess, but okay, so two teenage boys.
Let me get over here, because the light. Okay.
Two teenage boys, where are they going to sleep? I need beds. So when I ordered these, I also ordered these Murphy beds, which I had the carpenter build a wall around. They're amazing beds. They totally have completely good pillow-top mattresses on them. And this is where the boys sleep when they come home. And Joe is sleeping here right now, so I have this one. And then, excuse Joe's mess in the corner, but there's another one right there.
Perfect.
So, yeah,
that's so amazing.
No,
I haven't
awesome.
Seen anything like this in downtown.
No, it's amazing. Everyone that comes in is pretty stoked. They'll comment on how comfortable bed is, so that's kind of boning. So yeah, it's super cool. And then when they're not here, it just turns right back into the living room.
And you even have like storage stuff up
there.
Yeah,
I'm actually about to build a cabinetry that's going to go over that in the next couple of weeks.
That's
cool.
Should
have a little bit more storage space. And then behind you, Ted, this is... I'm not a big TV person, I mean I have it, but this is where I just keep it all. So right now, we have the television and the stereo and everything.
Mm-hmm.
The speaker system is all good. So that's that.
The cool thing about this loft is, I guess, the reason you don't need a big TV is because it's really set up to be more of a social gathering place.
It's definitely a social gathering place.
Now, what's awesome, it's a rainy day today, and you can't really see the skyline usually how it looks, but this is a spectacular view.
Okay, I'm going to open up the window. Isn't that amazing?
I mean, I'm just saying that it's usually blue skies.
Right, no, it is. But there's something special about it when it's not blue skies.
Yeah, you hardly ever see rain clouds.
Mm-hmm.
So you're right, this is a...
That's a really nice level to be at. Actually, Ted, if you look out the window over here, you can see the 10 freeway, which is always a very nice gauge of traffic.
Mm-hmm. You're right.
It's so easy to get places from here. We've got the 10,
say,
the 5, the 101.
Based on what we're seeing, we could get to the beach in about 25 minutes.
20 minutes, they do
20,
it.
Yeah.
In the morning,
it's
20
moving.
Minutes. When I go surfing in the morning. So yeah, 20 minutes easy.
But that is such an awesome view.
Mm-hmm.
It's like framed perfectly.
Yeah, and just, I don't know if you guys know, but just in front of... These are the townhouses that they built, but just in front of that we have this amazing swimming pool. We should look at it later.
Yeah.
It's like, it's 50 meters long, no, 25 meters long. It's gorgeous, outside heated. It's really, and saline, which is fantastic too, just so we're not dealing with chlorine.
So show me, basic stuff, like the other bathrooms.
Okay,
so you actually have two bathrooms. Laundry.
Bathroom. Okay.
Just like the nitty gritty.
The nitty gritty. So yes, we have two bathrooms.
I just love these couches.
They're so comfortable.
It's perfect for TV watching.
Yes, these are TV watching couches. No, it's fantastic. I have friends come over all the time just to be cozy and watch TV.
And then I see right up here, that's the air conditioning duct.
That's
so
the
it's
the duct. It goes all the way through. Heating and air conditioning.
Did you?
Obviously.
Was that like, no.
No, we had to change it when I built the wall.
Yeah, that's...
So we had to put a little kick in it.
Yeah.
Elbow.
It's good you did it.
Yeah.
So everybody can be comfortable everywhere.
So,
I love this view.
Isn't it great?
Yeah.
The reveal.
Is that you or me?
No, it's you.
Uh-oh.
Someone's calling you. You're a popular loft person.
No one ever calls me here. Okay, go ahead.
All right, so we've seen the one bathroom that was off my bedroom. And then we'll go back down towards the kitchen. Back to the hallway where will be the other bathroom. Your friends and family will happily go. That's through the kitchen. My little family hall of fame right here.
Before you show me the final touches,
mm-hmm.
Why did you, when you go back to when you first got here and you walked in, why did you pick this loft?
It was a whim. I was living in Hollywood. I had been living in a big house for a very long time with a pool, with a gardener, with the whole shebang. And I was, and the kids are actually just about to leave to go to school, and I was ready for a smaller space. Walked into the loft. This building was gorgeous. I wanted a much bigger space. I did not, this is 1800, and for some reason in my head, I had to have 22. So they were showing us around, and the kid that was showing us the places, he was only showing us the big spaces because he said, you know, that's what I said we wanted. And then he said, you know, if I was buying in this building, there's one unit I really want to show you that I would buy. I'm like, no, it's only 1,800 square feet. I don't want to see it. We walked in, walked down this hallway, came around the corner, and it's like, what do we need to put a deposit on this?
Right.
And it's because of the windows. We had the full south facing, we got west facing. It was like, it was so special to me.
And the saltwater pool.
Saltwater, the promise of the saltwater pool, because it wasn't there yet.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But no, it just did something to me. It's a really, really, really special space. And I think it's probably the light. I'm really driven by light. And
well, and it's also a lot of square footage, too.
It's a huge space. And once I got into it and then started building out, I thank God I didn't get any bigger, you know? I'm really happy with it.
So show me the last bit. I'll actually go in, take a look, is the bathroom. Got the shower. I love, that's a really nice shower.
Yeah, it's good. So the shower,
I'm a shower
the shower
guy.
Door. And the toilet.
And then the laundry, and then we're
laundry,
done.
I do apologize.
No,
it's, really
it's perfect,
really
it's working.
I was cleaning stuff behind the laundry when you came. But yeah, here's the laundry. It's
big
really
laundry
cool.
Closet.
No, it's great.
Perfect.
So, wash it dry.
Perfect. All right. Well, thanks for inviting me into your home.
Hey, anytime.
And any last thing you might want to say?
No, but trust me that it's a beautiful place.
Well,
and I actually love it.
We don't have to trust you. We just saw it. Thank you,
all
Vicki.
Right.
Okay, bye-bye.